This bard's tale begins near White Orchard, with my dear friend Geralt of Rivia seeking his lover of yore, the sorceress Yennefer. She'd eluded him for years, but now seemed just a few steps ahead. After many trials and tribulations, Geralt finally learned that Yen was in nearby Vizima.
It must suffice.
Think Emhyr cares if I'm clean.
The gentleman will refer to his Imperial Majesty by his full title or not at all. The gentleman will be seated on the bergère. Tetwin, please shave the gentleman's sideburns to half an inch.
What's wrong with my beard? Always thought it added to my dignity.
It does. Yet it also detracts from your elegance. In Nilfgaard, we consider beards hard on the eyes. Especially beards infested with lice.
Been on the road a while. Fine. Do your thing.
Tilt your head back, please. And sit still.
And prepare to answer some questions.
General, I am not certain this is the appropriate time.
I can't think of a better time. Men turn honest when they feel a blade at their throat. Morvran Voris, commander of the Alba Division. Before they take you in to see the Emperor, Witcher, there's some information I need you to verify. It's a formality. But one that must be seen to.
Sure. Paperwork's gotta be in order.
So, Geralt of Rivia. Place of birth, unknown. Parents, unknown. Age, unknown. All insignificant details. Let us proceed to more recent events. The siege of La Valette Castle. The fate of the defending commander, one Arya.
We fought on opposing sides, true. Then we landed in the same dungeon. Arian escaped, set fire to the castle on his way out.
So that is how the blade started. Our reports suggested the dragon was responsible. Moving on. You then found shelter in charming Flotsam, and from there made your way to Vergen. My question is how?
Okay, so let's guess again. Vernon.
I got out of Flotsam with Vernon Roach, commander of the Blue Stripes, and...
A murderer of non-humans. We know this gentleman well, Witcher. You forge interesting alliances.
Something tells me my most interesting is yet to come. Go on, next question, before my beard grows back in.
We shall shave you again if it does. Very well. The infamous summit at Lochmuin. You were there. And once again meddled in the affairs of the Mighty.
This one.
The Mighty had imprisoned Triss Marigold. Ought to know I care about her. And I tend to rescue those I care about.
And so you did, handing Radovid control of the Conclave and Council of Mages in the process.
Nilfgaard recently started a war. Unprovoked. So do us both a favor and stop moralizing.
The gentleman must sit still. I'm almost done.
I'm afraid I might find that difficult. Because, from what I know, shortly afterwards you watched a defective megascope blow your friend Sheila de Tansaville to bits.
Escaped.
I watched her get in the megascope, but ultimately freed her from the trap your man Letho of Gullet had set. Write that down. I want to be sure the paperwork's in order now.
Well, national interest calls on one to forge difficult alliances at times. Alliances with witches included.
That an ongoing alliance? What's Letho up to?
I had hoped you would answer that question.
Ah, so Letho's hiding from you. Must have a good reason. Was there a shift in national interest that might have caused that? I don't know where he is. Wouldn't tell you if I did anyway. Blade or no blade to my throat.
I believe that is all. Your signature, please, affirming you stated the whole truth and nothing but the truth on pain of imprisonment or death, etc., etc. Here and here.
With these formalities seen to, I would ask the general to leave the room. We shall be choosing the gentleman's attire. An important matter, but one that does not require the general's assistance.
Shame. I might have given you some advice. So long, Geralt. Good luck with your audience.
Feels more like I'm being readied for a wedding.
Were that so, I would have prepared the gentleman a frock, a tailcoat, or possibly a dinner jacket. In point of fact, the gentleman will choose from these garments.
Yeah, where are my clothes?
Where are my clothes?
Where they should have gone long ago, with the laundress. They will be returned to you after the audience, clean and starched. The gentleman will tell me once he has chosen an outfit.
Okay, so we're back to selecting our formal suits, and like to say thank you to one response to my question on Facebook. And for that, we're going to go with either A or C. I think we can go with this. Okay, so we're going with C. Okay, we're wearing this and this.
And they say clothes do not make the man. Does the outfit satisfy the gentleman?
A studded doublet and a sword on my back, that's what would satisfy me. But tough, when in Nilfgaard.
Yes?
It's a saying. So what now? Powder my nose?
No need. The gentleman's complexion is light enough. The gentleman is to stand before the ruler of the north and south. I must confirm that he knows how to bow.
Confirm away.
Please watch. Leg extended, hand flat, head down, chin to chest. The gentleman will rehearse. Lacking fluidity and grace. But we've learned to expect less of Nordlings. Come with me.
Okay, so we've been granted an audience.
The gentleman will address the Emperor only when asked to, and using the appropriate title.
Your Arch Magnificency.
I see the gentleman is in the mood for jests. I fear the Emperor might not share his disposition. Your Majesty will suffice. Spoken loudly, clearly, and with respect.
Imgrimi eb art kerzer. Dyfen aden in karn eb marvut. Emhyr var Emreis.
Bow. Your Imperial Majesty.
Arer ep do orde.
Avelian namen, vat gern favort. I thought you bowed before no man.
Didn't want to disappoint the Chamberlain. We're friends. Take it you didn't summon me to reminisce about the good old days, so...
Silence. My daughter Cirilla, she's returned. And she's in danger. The Wild Hunt pursues her. will find her and bring her to me.
Are you sure? Ciri left, went far, far away.
Do you believe I'd drag you here in the middle of a war to discuss a rumor?
I think anyone can be wrong, even an emperor.
I had forgotten how insolent you can be. I haven't the time to convince you, nor the desire, in fact. Yennefer will do that after the audience.
How many men in your army? 20,000? 30? So why me?
You know why. Because she trusts you.
She trusts me, yes. So tell me why you're looking for her. Doubt it's about making up for all those lost years.
For reasons of state, as always. Enough of this banter. You will agree regardless. If for no other reason than because I shall pay you more than you customarily receive for a contract. Considerably more.
Save your generosity for those whose homes your armies have raised. I'll do it for Ciri, not for your gold.
Your motives do not interest me. Only results. Yennefer will tell you the rest. This audience is finished. Merarid! Take him to the sorceress.
Follow me, if the gentleman pleases. Please keep close. There are many honorable guests in the palace whom the gentleman
disgusts.
Need not bother. Once the gentleman is done, he should see me to retrieve his possessions.
Yes? Then transcribe. The true authority in Novigrad is not the city council or the merchant's guild, but the Church of the Eternal Fire and the criminal underworld. At times, it is difficult to tell the one from the other. They both display a similar ruthlessness and cynicism that...
Please wait, Your Excellency. I'm falling behind.
You know what? I'll write the report myself. You'll need only prepare a clean draft. In triplicate.
A shame I have no time.
Geralt, that tunic. You look positively smashing.
Dying to take it off.
I'd consider that a proposition under different circumstances. One I might even take you up on. But we've matters to attend to. Now do you understand why I'm at Emhyr's court?
Mm-hmm. And seems we're in the same boat now. Ciri, she's really back? No chance he's mistaken?
Look, that's more or less what she looks like now. Or so our agents claim. Our little witch has grown into a young lady.
How about that? She's grown up.
It's been years since you trained together at Kaer Morhen. A great deal has changed.
You haven't. Not a bit.
I missed those awkward compliments of yours. But let's focus on Ciri, all right?
Right. Emhyr said the Wild Hunt's after her. I'd find that hard to believe, before what happened yesterday. How did they track us down?
Because of me. You see, I've spent months searching for Ciri. Using locating spells, haruspicy, geomancy, anything, really. I knew the Wild Hunt might sense it, perhaps even find me, but... I thought I'd tricked them.
Well, guess you were wrong.
I've sensed them on my trail, hunting me, for some time. If not for you and Emhyr's soldiers, they'd have gotten what they were after. I can't risk another encounter like that. It's time to put away the magic, turn to more traditional methods. To the best tracker I know. You must find her, Geralt, before the Wild Hunt does.
The Wild Hunt? What could it want from Ciri?
I've no clue, Geralt. Might have written them to ask, but I don't have their address. I know as much as you do. It must be about her blood. Her gift. As for what the hunt wishes to do with that gift, I'd prefer not to think about it, really.
So where has Ciri been seen, exactly?
In two places. Velen and Novigrad. The trail in Velen is most promising. You should make that your first stop. Ask for a merchant named Hendrik at the inn at the crossroads. One of the Emperor's agents. He should get in touch with you.
That's it? No passwords? Secret handshakes?
None. Sorry to spoil your fun. Your boyhood fantasies about the crafts of the trade. All we have in Novigrad are unconfirmed reports, rumors. But there you will have the help of our mutual acquaintance, Triss Merigold. Apparently she's got a cozy flat on the main square.
Sure she'll be delighted to see me. What about you? What will you do?
I shall sail for Skellige. There was a magic explosion there recently, blew half a forest down. I believe this had something to do with Ciri. I'll be in Caer Trold. Join me there once you've learned something.
One thing before we go. Why didn't you contact me? Didn't need me? Didn't even want to see me?
I didn't want to spoil things. I'd heard you and Triss made a great couple.
Yen, I'd lost my memory.
Really? That's your excuse? Let's drop it, all right? It's not what you think, or it helped me understand how much I love you. I don't wish to hear it. Any of it.
Guess this means we need to split up again. Not my preference, but I understand. Clock's ticking.
It is indeed. So why don't I teleport you to Velen, get you there at once?
Not gonna happen. I'll go on horseback, as soon as I can get changed.
Have it your way? Oh, and you really look quite dashing in black velvet.
Think so? Maybe I can have some of my armor lined with it. Good luck, Yen.
Same to you. And if you wish to learn what's happened in the world while you and Vesemir roamed the wilderness, talk to Ambassador Vaartra. That's him over there. And Geralt, I know it's wartime, but try not to be a hero, all right? Just check those leads and come back to me, in one piece. I shall be waiting.